And we're live with UFO Love, coast to coast and around the globe. Woo! Give it up. Live from Turtle Island. Today I have a special guest in the studio with me named Chelsea. She's inspiring me to dedicate this show to the universal language, commonly known as gibberish. Do you want to say anything, Chelsea? She gave me a strange look. Because, you know, the studio is basically, it's my iPhone and earphones. So for a small being like Chelsea, she doesn't really know what's going on. Oh, yeah, she understands what I'm saying, but there's no response. She just, like, shook her head, like, no. Yes, but the kulu bullet. Kilup. Kilup. Get up. She keeps saying no, just no. Okay. Anyway, I hope to those who understand what I'm saying. Hello. Welcome to the show today. Okay. So start by in the tradition that we've maintained so far with these webcasts to tune in with the Adi Mantra, Ong Namo Gurudev Namo. It's an ancient language, so it has its roots in gibberish too. Ong Namo Gurudev Namo. I bow to the great wow, the cosmic wow. And Chelsea's looking at me like, what's going on here right now? so I like to gesticulate too. This is the other part of the universal language for me. Gibberish and gesture. Our hands, our eyes, our facial expressions, our body. Dance. To dance is to communicate, isn't it? And it's understood by all. Dance and music. Okay, are you Chelsea? Okay, so rub your hands together. Come so. Relax your shoulders. See a few deep breaths. Breathing deeply. Deep inhale. Complete exhale. Push all the air out. All that stale air. Let it go. Let it go. Another deep inhale. Inhale. Deeply exhale. Inhale to begin. Do it three times. Inhale. Om. Namo. Gurudev. Sadgurename, Jugadgurename, Sadgurename, Siri Guru Deve Name. Had Gure Name. Jugad Gure Name. Sat Gure Name. Siri Guru Deve Name. Had Gure Name. Jugad Gure Name. Sat Gure Name. Siri Guru Deve Name. Inhale deeply. Hold the breath. Apply root lock. Hold it. Release. Slowly. Enjoy the silence. My tiny friend here, tiny in size, huge in heart. Infants teach us so much. Sensitive to loud noise. Children, like animals of the forest, all animals are hypersensitive. Thus, it's okay. Do you want to say something? See how she's doing here, and play some music. It might help to calm. Oh, here we go, Nightingale. Of the story of Byron, Lord Byron and Shelley, two English poets, extraordinary poets. They said that they saw a mother passing on the street with a child. They would stop to ask, speak to the child about the other world or past life. Based on the theory that the first 3 years, child still has a very clear memory of their previous life, the other side. Maybe Maybe they use gibberish to this to communicate. It's fascinating that we come into this world without any established language. The only language is gibberish. Mm-hmm. In the earliest stages. Let's hear it for Singkar. Ensemble. Getting some gibberish messages in. Thank you, Dragona. I haven't got the Skype hookup yet, because it would be nice to... We'll do some more gibberish shows in the future. Don't worry about that. So I want to get all of the people who speak this language to come and share. Maybe this is the new tribe, universal, international tribe, heart-to-heart speakers. I just love that we come into this world without any prescribed language other than this, right? The primal sounds, the nad vibration, the sound of laughter. Sometimes it looks like crying too, you know. which brings up an interesting... What is it, Chelsea, now? Brings up an interesting... phenomenon for me is that when we cry, we really cry from deep in the soul, it is very much the same experience, I think, as laughter. It's real laughter. It's, in other words, Kundalini is evoked and stimulated, and it's moving. We're moving energy. It's cleansing. When we cry or laugh from this deep level, tears often come. Yes? And the tears are cleansing. Yeah, and they come from another realm. They come from that other side that the infant still remembers. I think that's why infants cry as much as they laugh, because they're wanting to go back home like me. So I'd like to sing a song. A gibberish song. Chelsea's asked me to play a little bit lighter. It's that sensitivity, you know, that we come into the world with this beautiful sensitivity, all the senses so finely tuned, like a wild animal. And then our senses get dulled, you know, and we turn up the music louder and driving in traffic with the sound of motor cars and other noise pollution, and our senses become kind of immune to this sound. So I'm going to play it more gently. It's good. Yeshua Magdalene. Yeshua Magdalene. Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Padme Hum. Stifled laughter. It's a little bit crazy. But the music's helping. Okay? And I was just saying, as I'm singing this song, I'm thinking, you know, from it wasn't that long ago, and even today, maybe in some places, one could be excommunicated or even tortured and burned at the stake for making a statement like Jesus and Mary Magdalene produced a child named Sarah together. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, that's what the song is about. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme into gibberish mode, speaking in tongues, because, you know, gibberish, there's a very fine line between gibberish and speaking, what people call speaking in tongues. One can notice, if you practice with this long enough and in different states of consciousness, you know, shamanic states of consciousness, you notice different qualities. We might get visions to smells, sounds that come with the tongue that's coming through. For me, sometimes Africa, for example, then the sounds can be more like and I had the good fortune of going to yeah, thank you. I had the good fortune going to Mali a few years ago, West Africa, and to travel up in the escarpment where the Dogon people live. If you ever get a chance, it's worth the trip. They haven't changed their way of life, maybe thousands of years. So they had those amazing cliff dwellings too, that people still can't figure out how they built them, how they even got up to them. and their language, the language of the Dogon people, isn't too much unlike what I was just doing. This kind of thing. And it's just beautiful to listen to it. And part of their way is when you pass someone, it could be someone you see every day, several times a day, always stop to greet one another, and these greeting ceremonies can take sometimes half an hour. It's like, just say hello, how are you, and it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's like they're singing to each other. There could be more than two people, of course. It could be a whole chorus, people, and our interpreter is telling us that basically they're just saying, "How are you? Everything well? How is your family?" And it's the most beautiful thing to see, and especially juxtaposed against what I've been experiencing, and it's much even more difficult having been to places like Mali to walk on streets here in North America and Europe where people don't even make eye contact often, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, that's when, like Chelsea, I want to say, bring me home right now. I want to go home, okay? You know, at least, you know, make eye contact, nod to the person that you're passing. Take the initiative, too. If enough of us take the initiative to, you know, to initiate some kind of connection with strangers that we pass on the street, then by and by the miracle happens. Hallelujah. We don't feel like strangers anymore. Hallelujah. 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 Chelsea's falling asleep right now. Hallelujah. So she's somewhere between sleeping and crying. Maybe she'll get a blanket or something. Get a blanket. Do you want to come over? Want to come? You want to stay there? She's like, the 2-year-olds, they know what they want, even though they don't really know what they want. get her blankie. Oh, here we are. Come over here. You want to come? I get a blankie. Come on. Yeah, oh good, she's getting up on the couch now. There you go. Oh, she likes this. I think it's one of her favorite blankets. There you go. Yay. Hallelujah. 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 Sing with me. Hallelujah. 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 So I'm just getting readjusted here. I'll put on another song. Put on one of mine. How's that? Do you like that idea? Oh, okay. Do you insist? Let's see. That's a nice gentle one. Salt City, City of Call.
I'm ready.
City of Call. Maha Call. Maha Call Satanam. Call Murit. Vaheguru. Vaheguru.
City of Call, Mahakal,
Satanam,
call it Waheguru. Sat City, City of Call. City of Call,
Mahakal,
Mahakal, Satanam,
call Murit,
Wahe. Vahe Guru. Vahe Guru. Sat Siddhi, Siddhi Akar, Siddhi Akar, Mahakar, Mahakar, Satana, Kalmurit, Vahe Guru. City, Vahe Guru. Vahe Guru. Sat Siddhi, Siddhi Akal.
We are eternal beings.
Siddhi Akal, Mahakal, Mahakal, Satana, Kalmurit, Vahe Guru. Sat
City,
City Akal, City Akal, Mahakal, Mahakal, Satana, Kalmurit, Vahe Guru, Sat.
City,
City Akal, City Akal,
it's really reaching those high notes. Give it up. Hare Rama. Hare Rama.
Hare Rama. Vahe Guru. Vahe Guru.
Deathless image of God. God presence. Akal Murit. Vahe Guru. Wow. God is great. God is great. God is great. It's indescribable bliss. Vahe Guru. What, no applause? Come on. Oh, here we go. This is sweet. My partner here in the studio today, she's in the blanket and she's got a big teddy dog. It's bigger than her. His name. She's sleeping, so I'm going to be trying to be quiet. Kilipulu, kilipulu, kilikilikapu, pikita. Sekadakato, petitidu, pakalo, lakapuni, titapong, tatiko, pudik. I did some beatbox a few days back, you know. You can see that there's a strong kind of connection, that beatbox gibberish thing, you know, like. Wow. Oh, yeah. I was getting to it before we put the music on. I'm also offering my services. I've had this opportunity on occasion to play mediator for disputes. if you have a dispute right now, a conflict that you want to settle, call me. UFOs on the scene. here's an interesting thing, you know, the Dogon connection again. In Dogon tribe, West Africa, the council, the elders meet, they built these council areas outside, it's roofed in, purposely at a certain height that it's only, you know, less than standing height. In other words, so everyone's sitting down, and if somebody gets too irate, you know, too much anger, the idea is that, you know, that they'll go to stand up and they'll hit their head on the ceiling. That's what we were told, I was laughing. I was like, wow, that's great, because that would go perfectly with some ideas I have for anger management and settling disputes. One of them, and these are trademarks, by the way. Okay, so so expect royalties. Okay, if you're going to use these techniques, right, at home or in your business. the United Nations, perhaps. What do you think? Do you think I should run for president, or emperor of the United Nations? Yeah? Give it up. What do you think? Yeah? Okay. You feel love at the UN, all right? Dolphin kisses to all of you out there. perfectly timed. Received a beautiful dolphin image. Thank you, Dragana, for that. Because this is one of the techniques, actually. It's dolphin medicine for settling disputes. From family quarrels right up until United Nations, you know, the Cold War, which seems to be brewing again between the U.S. and USSR. Yay, give it up for Vladimir Putin. Woo! back in the USSR. So dolphin medicine, here's how it works, okay? You can try this next time you have a quarrel argument. The rule is simple, okay? Are you listening? Pay attention. The rule is, this is where it's good to have a mediator. You can call me, okay? Just call me anytime, anywhere, any place, as long as you have a Wi-Fi. We'll do it, right? You can even do it with Skype, with video. And we'll have Skype, by the way, right here on the live webcast with UFO Love very soon. So I guess that means I can have multiple callers at the same time. I'll have to look into that, but I'm pretty sure that's doable. So maybe we'll do some mediation right here live on the air, coast to coast and around the globe. And here's one of the techniques again. So you and your spouse, your boss, whoever the other conflictor, That's part of the problem right there, isn't it? We love to point the finger at the other person as the source of the problem. and they're doing the same thing. You. which reminds me that saying, you know, when you point your finger at another person, yes, three fingers are pointing back, right back at you. So here it is. So you come to me live on the air, if you have the guts to do that, right? So it could get messy. The first thing I might say is, okay, silence. Let's take a few deep breaths like we do at the beginning of each program. Let's tune in, Adi Mantra, Mangalacharan Mantra. Ad Gure Namah, Jugad Gure Namah, Sat Gure Namah, Siddhi Guru Deva Namah. Create a safe space. Get under that roof, that, you know, the one where you hit your head if you stand up too abruptly. and then once we're ready to roll, here's how it rolls. You have to settle the dispute, and I'm going to also moderate in terms of who gets to speak when. Right, because that's a very key part of this process, is that everybody gets a chance to speak and to be heard. So that we can address this in a mature, hopefully somewhat mature way. You know. Here's where it gets really fun. You could call this immature, but it's actually, everything is upside down, inside out, and backwards. Right? The rule is, this is technique number one, that everyone has to speak in dolphin language. Are you with me? it takes a little practice, so I might have to give some instruction for some help. it shouldn't take long. It's like this. So, it's like, is it good? Okay. You know, imagine yourselves, you're arguing, you know, whatever the argument is, converting it into dolphin language. Don't you think by within a minute or maybe 2 minutes, the most you'd be laughing at your guts? yeah, that's one of the techniques, okay, that I'll use, because for me it's almost impossible. If that doesn't work, you know, if the... That one doesn't work. I have a backup. Okay, so don't worry. There is a backup, right? In fact, I have a whole shitload of techniques. But here's another one, very very similar to the dolphin medicine dispute settlements technique, and this is, it's called whispering, okay? Whatever the dispute is, we have to whisper. And whispering isn't like this. You know, whispering is a whisper. It's like the wind. You know, you have to totally... There's no tone really in the whisper, right? There's no tone. Can you guys hear me okay? Give it up if you can hear me still, okay? Thank you, Chelsea. She's sleeping now. Is there anything more beautiful than a sleeping infant? I don't think so. Don't wake her up now. Uh, because this is part of the poop story for me. The origin's mine, and I've heard this story too many times from other clients, students, and friends who had to suffer through their childhood, hearing parents, their own parents, screaming at each other. I certainly did. It's one of the most horrific things for a child to hear their own parents, their old men, yelling at each other at the top of their lungs. Because for a child, being so super sensitive, it's comparable to murder itself, you know what I mean? And so to hear that even once could be very traumatizing. And to hear it over and over again, many of us had to endure before the inevitable divorce, in my case. it's work, right? It's work to let go of that, to release that. One of the things that I'm very excited about sharing in future webcasts is to do some soul retrieval work, once I have the Skype connection, and to invite people to do some soul retrieval work right here, live on the air. What do you say? Let's do it, okay? Children are beautiful teachers, and you know, our society has cut us off from one another in so many ways. You know, the old saying, divide and conquer. So children go to daycare from a young age, often into school, of course. Parents are working hard to feed the child, to clothe them, keep them warm, shelter. You know, it's insane, right? I mean, think about it. The parents end up, in a lot of cases, not even having much quality time with the children because they're too busy working and driving them around to different places, daycare and other activities, and working more and more to keep all of this together. And in the end, there's little time to really be together and just to share and celebrate. And also the way that communities have been divided as well. in terms of the homes, like think about the, especially in the suburbs, but even we see this in urban centers too, and rural places where people don't even know their own neighbors. They don't even know the names. Like, in a healthy community, we should know, you know, the 20 people living closest to us. We should know all of them, ideally, right? On a first name basis. How many people can honestly say this is the case? You know, it's a sign of the times. The different age groups are cut up too, divided, right, in the community. So the children are shipped off to the daycare and the schools where they're around only people of their age group. So it's very compartmentalized that way, and right up until, you know, college, and the adults work with the adults, and then there's the elders, right, who are then shipped off to nursing homes and other activities where they're not connected with the rest of the community. In the West, of course, it's very different in places like Mali and other parts of the world, so-called third world nations. I don't know about you guys, but I'm all for a third world. I mean, like, you can learn a lot, you know, so-called first world, whatever, industrialized. Can learn a lot from these traditional cultures. So what can we sing? Let me do something with the guitar. Gibberish, yeah, that's a little gibberish. What was I say? Gurmukhi kind of sounds like gibberish. Ekam ka satana vahe guru. 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 Doing some gibberish by texting, you know, you can do gibberish too, right? It's kind of fun. thank you, Bonnie, for checking in. the great thing, with, of course, with these webcasts is if you don't hear it live, you can listen to it later at your convenience, anytime, day or night, right here on Speaker. Texting, you know, especially with these touch screens now that we have on computers and iPads and smartphones, can do rapid typing, right? And it's fun just to do gibberish with your fingers, you know what I mean? Like, and what's even more funny about it is the auto, if you have autocorrect, does anybody use autocorrect besides me? It's funny. You can also call it spell check, or sometimes I prefer to call it spell funk, you know what I mean? Like, because it's funny to see some of the crazy words that come up from autocorrect. I swear to God, sometimes I feel like my iPhone is possessed by some crazy-ass spirit. Where did that come from? Like, these words. And there's no logic often. Almost sounds like they're not even English, if I'm in English. So what I notice, of course, with the autocorrect, if I try to type gibberish on the touch screen, then the autocorrect will try to correct the gibberish. You know what I mean? So sometimes you get these odd words just popping up. So it's a fun little exercise. If you want to play with me sometime, you can probably do that, okay? I like farting around a lot. oh, excuse me. oh, <sorry. coughs> yeah. Paula's name already came into my consciousness at the beginning of the show. My dear sister, who inspires me to this day, she departed. It's almost 30 years now since she left this planet. So I joke about it because I wish it was me instead of her. And she brought so much light and joy and bliss. She never really left, though, for me. She's been with me all these last 30 years. One of the ways that I celebrate her presence is when I'm walking on the sidewalk, as I mentioned earlier. Okay, you know where this is going. And somebody gives me, a nasty look. It's almost worse than not looking. It's when somebody looks, when they make eye contact with you for a split second. They look away or they make this kind of scowl look, just kind of nasty vibe, right? And so what I do then, if I see this kind of BS, I'll make a fake sound. If I can't do it for real, I'll make a and it excuse me as I'm walking. I always think of Paula and something that she would do. And so all kids can relate to it. Farting sounds. Let's try it. Isn't it great to do that thing with your lip, that raspberry sound? Here we go. So make that raspberry sound like this. Sing along. It's amazing the energy this can generate just doing this. Okay. Try it. I'm serious. The most serious of my life. Okay. People ask me, where are you from, UFO? Okay. Here it is. Thank you. Great. Before I continue with this raspberry song, call it the raspberry song, I have to get a drink of water. People ask me sometimes, where are you from? It's a pretty standard question. And my answer is, of course, Sirius. And because the nation known as Syria has been so much in the news, often they go, Syria? No, Sirius. And then I usually point upward, right, towards the sky. And then they start walking or running away because they think I'm a crazy madman. Which I am. Anyhow, one thing I like to tell people, if they don't run away, if they're still listening after that, is that people from Sirius, one of the ways to identify someone from Sirius, or to know that they're really from Sirius, because some people, there are imposters who like to say they're from Sirius, but they're not. It's easy. It's really easy to tell a true Syrian, I mean from the dog star, Sirius, from an imposter. We are the least serious people in the entire cosmos, okay? Let's give it up for Sirius. Yes. Woo! I spoke about aliens and extraterrestrials in a recent webcast. This is one way for me to define what is alien, what is extraterrestrial, is that against humor, sense of humor. Extraterrestrial, for me, has to have a sense of humor, right? It's, it's mandatory to be in this, especially coming down to a planet like this and to see all the poop. stories being farted all over the place. Got to keep a sense of humor, right? Aliens tend to be kind of dry and dead, right? The heart is closed, even though it's still there. They're not very funny. They're not much fun to be around, you know what I'm saying? Yet, we do what we can. But yeah, it's funny because I can tell an alien, Milo, I can smell him. I'm part wolf. And I'll give an alien some of my best humor, and still hardly get a response from them. Not even a smile sometimes. Like, whoa. Even encouraging them to do something, say something funny, and they can't. It makes me want to cry, scream, make an artificial fart like Paula would. Excuse me. Anyway, so I've got some water. And drink lots of water, everyone, okay? Do that for me. Good, pure water. Keep yourselves hydrated. Make sure the water is the right temperature. We don't want it too cold or too warm, right? Sometimes it's nice to have hot water, just a glass of hot water. Of course, you can add some tea to that as well. Some herbs, or different teas, green tea, black tea, white tea, purple polka dotted tea. knock yourself out, okay? Okay, so the raspberry song. It's going to call the raspberry song. Thank you for the inspiration, Chelsea, and all of you who are listening in right now. Thank you. So maybe just massage your face, especially around your mouth. You can do this with your but you want to relax your jaw, massage the muscles of TMJ. You know what I'm saying? TMJ tension is not fun. Temporal mandibular joint, the main joint of the jaw. You can see this in a lot of people, right? Their jaw is almost locked. Sometimes it's so tight, that joint. Scary. And that's the voice. Everything is affected. It can affect the hearing, the ability to hear, the ability to communicate. It's painful and creates headaches, all kinds of problems. So, excuse me, relax your jaw. And your lips, your mouth, and let's do some raspberry singing, okay? Like this. Sounds like an outdoor outboard motor. Right? you can call it that if you like. Saliva spraying all over the place. Yeah. It feels good, doesn't it? My lips feel like they've come back to life. Live lips. Also, this sound is good too. Use the tongue. It comes up. Children love this kind of stuff. In infancy, they inspire me to do all kinds of crazy things that, you know, I normally do anyway, but even more like this one. Try it. Okay, go on. It's your turn. I'm listening. After me. For kids to teach them, you know, dither, the word is dither, right? In English, I don't know, probably other cultures have different word for it. We say dither. Dither, dither, dither. Dither, dither. So, you know, kids get fascinated with their tongues, right? The tongues are starting to create language. The tongue is fundamental to enunciating and creating all these different sounds from the mouth. Right? I'm okay, I'll be all right. Trust me. I'm actually sober, believe it or not. So I've been teaching Nad Yoga. It's one of the 22 branches of Kundalini Yoga. Nad, again, refers to the sound current, vibration. I'm teaching this for many years. And one of the things I'll say in workshops is that we have 96, I believe, acupuncture points on the upper roof of the mouth, the palate. So different sounds, we enunciate different consonants and vowels and so on. The tongue will touch different parts of the palate and thus stimulate different acupoints on the roof of the mouth, which are, of course, are directly connected to the brain. So it's literally like a code. We've got the sacred code, you see, and this is why different languages and different words stimulate different responses in the psyche, in the consciousness. One of the things that makes mantra chanting kirtan so joyous, trust me on this, okay? I've been doing it. Again, I'm available right now here in Quebec and potentially all over the world, internationally, in outer space, even wherever there's a call, I'll be there. A call. A call. Timeless, deathless. Remember that where time does not exist, a call, in the eternal now, space does not exist either. You see that? Time and space are mutually dependent. Without one, the other one does not exist either. So time and space are both removed in akal. Akal. Language and Latin to some degree too are directly related to Sanskrit. It's a good example. Akal. Is the negation, the antithesis of the as a prefix. The word that follows in this case, kal. Kal means could be translated as kill. It's fascinating, isn't it? It means death. That's why, as I said, akal translates as deathless, eternal. Kal, then, is death. And you see right there, kill, kal. City means great. Maha is great too. It's a different flavor of great. It's beautiful things about Sanskrit, these words describing subtle aspects, nuance of things that are really meaningful on the spiritual level. How to give words to describe the indescribable, something else. Mumuksha, mumuksha. Shunyata, mumuksha, mumuksha, shunyata. So remember, if you have a dispute, well, the best thing to do is first call me, and I'll be happy to moderate, mediate. I'll ask you first maybe to try the dolphin technique. Like, I don't have my dolphin. The other response. Before you know it, they're both laughing. What was that all about? Like, I don't know. And my whole only role is to make sure they keep their voices in the dolphin range. Like, failing that, of course, we've got the backup, which is to whisper. To whisper. You know, when you leave the cap on, the toothpaste tube, I get really angry in the morning. I don't like seeing that toothpaste coming out of the toothpaste tube when I come into the bathroom and smelling the smell from the toilet. And the other person has to keep their voice in a whisper too. They're like, oh yeah, well you think my, you, oh yeah. You know, it's like, before you know it, they're both laughing. They have to. Could it be that simple? So where are we? Well, we passed the hour mark. I think I've tortured you guys enough, eh, for today. How about some Cat Stevens? Of course, Yusuf Islam.
Now I've been happy lately, thinking about the good things to come.
Give it up. Yusuf Islam.
Something good has begun. Oh, peace train sounding louder.
Ride on the peace train. Ooh, ooh. Ride the other way.
Come on, the peace train. It's peace train, holy roller.
Everyone jump up on the peace train.
Ooh, ooh.
Ride the other way.
Come on. Good friends too, 'cause it's getting near. world as it is. Why must we go on hating? Why can't we live in bliss? 'Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country. Come take me home again. Oh, peace train, sounding louder.
Ride on the peace train.
Come on, the peace train. It's peace train, oh, it rolling.
Everyone jump on the peace train.
Chelsea.
Come on, peace train. Yes, it's the peace train.
Good time. Do you want to say the thing to our listeners, Chelsea? She's wiping her eyes. So cute to watch those little chubby baby, two and a half year old hands rubbing the eyes. One of the things that makes children so beautiful is that their eyeballs are, I think, the eyeballs are pretty much full size, like, from birth, eh? That's why, one of the reasons why children are so adorable, because big eyes, the head is still developing, the eyes are, like, fully developed, some size. Oh no, kilikuluku. Do you want to say anything to the Yes, I also offer babysitting services, yeah, I make the parents sign a waiver for the radio show. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, she'll be okay. Shh. We'll use that dispute technique, okay? The whisper one, okay? We can do whisper. This is a good one, too. There are some tribes, actually, that use this kind of sound as part of their language, you know? Like, darling, I'm on the air right now, please. There you go, come on. Okay, we'll finish with this long-time son. Hopefully this will help. Chanson du soleil. Chanson du soleil, would you like? You've been really great. Let's give Chelsea a big hand for supporting us.
Guide your way.
This is the time I wish I could produce breast milk. May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on, guide your way on. Oh, Flossie. Oh, Flossie. Puis tu jure le soleil clair, l'amour couturé, et en toi la couleur guide ta voix. Puis toujours le soleil t'éclairer, l'amour t'entourer, deeply. My prayers go out to all children around the globe, to the mothers and fathers who are taking care of them right now. God, blessed be. To the sound of laughter and crying, beautiful, all of it beautiful, and the pure sound of the heart, the gibberish love. Over and out. Bye-bye.